suffers. Torn apart by Dong Zhuo's cruel tyranny. Yuan Shao, my friend, leader of the coalition.
YouTube, what the crap's going on? Heir of Carthage here. That's right, we have news on Total War, Three Kingdoms. So, the news is pretty interesting. First, we get this Cao Cao trailer. Cao Cao, I guess. That sounds like what they were saying. I'm just starting to read the history in this period. So, obviously, this is actually set in the end of the Han Dynasty in China. A period of great turmoil and apparently a lot of drama. And it's going to be interesting because they said that this was the first Total War game that was going to use a romanticized version of history. Now, right when I say that, I'm sure there's a rabid group of fans that are like, no, no, the historical games, they have to be 100% historic. Okay, I know. There's a rabid fan base out there that insists that sometimes even to the detriment of gameplay, that these games should be historically accurate. And that's okay if that's a thing that you like. Guess what? We learned that there's going to be two modes. The default mode of Three Kingdoms is going to actually be the romanticized version, which to me is really cool because what I think we're going to get is some of the things that made Warhammer awesome, the character development, the abilities, and maybe even some legendary items and other stuff, training, who knows what all. I think we're going to see all that stuff come to the table. We don't know for sure yet exactly what we get, obviously. But I think we're going to see that character development and quest and other things mixed into a historical game. And we're told that in the romanticized default version of the game, these heroes, like Cao Cao here, again, if I'm saying it wrong, I apologize. Chinese obviously is not a first, second, third, or even fourth language for me, or any for that matter. But in any case, yes, they say that the heroes will be able to take on like hundreds of rank and file soldiers, which to me sounds fun. I think it fits the genre. I'm not super familiar with the Romance of the Three Kingdoms, but apparently it's this tale of great deeds and, you know, amazing feats and other stuff like that. And so I think it's cool because it's going to fit the culture that that story was written in, right? And some part of me almost wishes that that could have been present in Shogun 2, right? Because it's another game that could have benefited from it. Imagine Uesugi Kenshin or Takeda Shingen or, Tokugawa Ieyasu, all these people having these crazy character feats, which they did to an extent, right? Because you could level your general up and make him awesome. That kind of existed in Avatar mode when you're playing multiplayer, but it didn't really translate over into the campaign. So I'm kind of hoping that's what we're going to get in Three Kingdoms. I'm hoping that this romanticized version will really capitalize on the elements of Warhammer, those fantasy elements that make the game amazing to play over and over and over again. And then I hope they can mix that with a bit of history and just really come up with something special. That's what I want to see here, because for me, for instance, going, and again, a lot of this is personal opinion, but, you know, that's what this is. It's a video to give you my thoughts on this. So, there's a romanticized default, and then there's the classical mode. The classical mode promises to be more like your traditional Total War. Your general will be part of a bodyguard. He's not going to be some invincible Hulk, and obviously things will be different. So, I think what CA is doing here is really pretty smart. Let's split the difference. Let's take our fans that really enjoy the more exciting, dramatic type of gameplay that comes with some of these romanticized or almost fantasy type elements, and we'll mix that with the history, and then for the other folks, we'll give you the classical mode, which means that you don't have to go down that road. You can play the game, and you can do it in this classical mode. It'll be more like a traditional Total War. So I think it's pretty neat that they're offering both, and I'm really excited to see that. Very, very excited. So I'm hoping, again, that this will allow the game to have a great deal of diversity. Some people may be worried, saying, oh, well, it's set in, you know, a somewhat enclosed theater, right? It doesn't involve all these different countries. Well, I mean, we had games like Total War Attila, for instance, that were set all over the old ancient world of Europe and North Africa and in the Near East, and still the factions weren't very diverse. So I don't know if it makes a difference, whereas Shogun 2 was very popular, very successful, even on a focus scale as small as Japan. So I actually think that this setting will be fantastic. And I think it's going to lend itself to a lot of fun gameplay, a lot of fun units, and I'm extremely excited for it. Definitely excited. We got to see some in-game or in-engine footage is what we were seeing here, and it's looking darn good. So it's exciting to see. The art and style of it looks very nice. Again, this isn't a finished game by any stretch, but it already looks like it's kind of fitting the art style that we would expect for this. So very excited. Anyway, romanticized version of history. I'm all for it. I think this is great. And some of you might be, Eric, you just say whatever CA wants. No, it's the same. They asked us for feedback. It's the same feedback I gave them. I think this is a great move. Personally, I would have just done the romanticized thing, and I wouldn't have spent any time doing the classical one, because honestly, I have a hard time believing, and prove me wrong, I'm happy to be proved wrong on it. I just have a hard time believing that a historical total war without some of this romanticized stuff will ever match Warhammer. Historical total war is fantastic. It really is. But when the game takes a step, in my opinion, in a direction where the gameplay just becomes so much more replayable and so much more exciting, I like to see what they're doing here. But I also like the fact that, unlike me, they were kind enough to stay true to some of the original fans, and they're going to make sure that you get that classic mode so that you have an opportunity to play this the way that you used to. Anyway, what do you all think? I want to see your thoughts in the comments. This is all I know about this right now. I'm going to have to go start reading up the history. You can go start reading the history. I'm going to leave you the link to a Total War blog. In fact, we can swap over to that real quick. So let's jump over. There's this blog here, and I will leave you the link to this, and it's going to tell you a little bit more about what's going on. But I mean, I gave you the brief rundown essentially there. They tell you that it's based on the historical novel Romance of the Three Kingdoms. So if you want to go read this, it may give you a little background into it. And then in terms of a history book, they also tell you which history book that they're pulling from. It was somewhere right here. Qin Shao's 3rd century text. So they're pulling from the historical and from this cultural work here, the Romance of the Three Kingdoms. So definitely pretty exciting. Again, classic mode is the option that you can opt over to, and really all they say about it right now is in classic mode, your general will appear in battle the way you might expect in a classical Total War general to do. They're only human. They'll march into battle at the center of a bodyguard unit. There you go. And in the default mode, what they say right here is that your heroes take center stage in battle, helping to turn the tide with their flamboyant wushu martial arts or strategic prowess. To me, that sounds way more exciting. But, I mean, if you're one of the folks in it for the classic mode, great. I'm happy we both get to have something here. So, I think this is great. Again, that's my thoughts. Please leave your thoughts in the comments. Tell me what you think. Tell me what you want CA to do with this game. What do you think they could do that would be cool? What kind of units do you expect? What kind of campaign map are you hoping for? Obviously, it's set in China, you know, but just kind of curious to get some thoughts out there. I'm excited to learn more. I'm hoping maybe we'll get some more information as E3 rolls around. I think it's next week or later this week. I don't know. We'll see. So we'll see what happens there. Anyway, leave me your thoughts. HeirofCarthage, signing out for now. I'll be back with some more Three Kingdoms news as soon as I have it.